Hi, everybody. Ian Eagle from CBS Sports, joined by my son. What is it? Jonah? Noah?
Oh. So just because we have a role reversal doesn't mean you have to bring back history. Okay. It is Noah. It's like the Ark, two animals at a time. You created it.
Yeah.
You created me.
2 years ago, Noah and I had an interview prior to a Syracuse-Miami game that aired on CBS Sports.
Ian? I'm sorry.
You don't know
what
my
is
name?
What's the first name?
It's Ian. It's just like Brian. You take the BR off. We've been through this. You're my son. We thought this would be a pretty good time for an update. Considering what's happening in the world right now, I think this situation is fairly common. You're living out in Los Angeles,
yeah,
working with the LA Clippers, but you are now back home in New Jersey. How's that going for you?
It's going great. I'm back on scholarship. So for me, it's been fantastic. I have become so accustomed to grabbing everything myself and going out and running errands. That's not necessarily the case anymore. I'm back to my old ways.
I don't know if you've noticed, though, while you were gone for an extended mm-hmm. period of time, we were looking to make your room into something very different, either a yoga studio, meditation room, man cave.
Okay.
It's not the room that you left behind. Your bedroom looks significantly different.
Well, first and foremost, a man cave?
Yeah.
When have you ever been a man cave type of guy?
Maybe I can be a man cave type of guy. I would love to
see the man cave. Is this going to be like Summer of George type of situation? Summer of Ian? Are you going to have a little compartment at your chair?
I would love that.
Either way,
I'd love to nap.
Seriously, I came home and half of the items in my room were expunged, completely gone.
They're gone.
Now it's my bed, which is smaller than the one that I have in LA. Now that I'm thinking about it, why did I come home during this whole situation?
We've been asking that question a lot around
yeah,
here. In fact,
I can imagine.
Let me ask you something else, because 2 years ago you interviewed me.
Mm-hmm.
I have some questions for you.
Fire away.
Something that I've noticed here. Is it a God-given talent or learned behavior, the ability to sleep until noon every day?
I ask myself that pretty much every day. It's not just sleeping till noon. It's sleeping on planes. It's sleeping at a random point in the day.
That's a gift.
I would say it's a gift, and I thank God every day for giving me that gift because it is extremely useful.
Food consumption.
Mm-hmm.
You're how old now? How long have we been father-son?
23 and a half years, about?
23 and a half years. I am amazed by how much food you can take in a sitting. It's impressive. It's prodigious.
I grew up, I idolized the likes of Joey Chestnut and Kobayashi. I just felt like I had something in there. So the sleeping is God-given. The eating, it's hard work that went into it.
Do you have any questions for me at this stage?
I always have questions for you. I would say now that I've been back, my sister Erin is home, we've got our dog roaming around the house.
Yeah.
Where would you rank each of us in our quarantine behavior?
Whoa.
Yeah.
I'm going to say incomplete.
Whoa.
We are not completely through the quarantine
yet.
So give me a little bit of time.
That's fair. I've always been a patient guy. I've been patient and willing to wait for my report cards, but I do expect high remarks. Let's just put it that way.
All right. We hope everybody is safe. And please, social distance, be the best version of yourself, and we'll talk to you down the road.